To draw a nut and bolt in AutoCAD, first of all you choose workspace switching from status bar and click on the 3D modeling. Now take a polygon from draw toolbar, enter the number of sides which I have given 6, press enter. Now specify the center point of polygon and click on inscribe. Now specify radius of circle. I have assigned it 20. Now take a line from draw toolbar and click first point as a corner of the polygon and second point as a front corner of the polygon. Now press enter. Again take a circle from draw toolbar and specify center as midpoint. Now draw a circle of 10 mm radius. Again take a circle from draw toolbar and same center. Draw a circle of 20 mm or click on this corner point. Now change its view as a isometric by clicking here. Here the view has been changed from 2D to isometric view. And now extrude. First of all extrude the circle. And hexagon. Now assign height of 20. Press enter. Now from 2D wireframe, just choose realistic. And now subtract, take a command from solid editing toolbar and subtract. Select the hexagonal object, press enter. Now select the cylindrical object, press enter. Here we can see the hole. Now extrude the another circle, press enter. Specify height of extrusion as 20. Now from modify toolbar use fillet command which here is given. Now select the corner. Specify radius as 3. Enter. Now select the another corner. Press enter. Now from solid editing choose the command intersect and click on the both solid and press enter. Now this will looks like this. Now for the thread, you take a helix from draw toolbar. Click on the center point of the line or center point of the circle and specify radius as 10. Now specify the top radius again as 10 and press enter. Now you can choose turns, number of turns by clicking on the turns and assign number of turns as 10. Press enter. Now specify height of helix which is 20. Now draw a circle at outside of radius 0.5 and take a command sweep from modeling toolbar. Select circle, press enter. Now select helix. This circle will get the size of shape of helix. Here we can see. Now from solid editing toolbar, click on the subtract, click on the outer object, press enter. Now click on the inner object to subtract it. Now press enter. Here it will make a thread, as we can see. Now our knot is ready. Now for the wall, same process is applied, something different. First of all, now you can take the hexagon of side 6, specify radius, our center point. Now specify radius is 20. Now again from draw toolbar, take a line, first corner, second corner, enter. Now circle, center point, radius 10, enter. Now again a circle, center point, and radius 20, enter. And now extrude this. From modeling toolbar, take extrude command, click on the inner circle, enter, and specify height of extrusion, that is 60, enter. Now again take a extrude command and click on the hexagon, press enter. Now extrude it 20. Again extrude the circle, Now we can take the fillet command from modify toolbar. Click on the corner of the solid, specify radius as 1. Press enter. Again enter. Now we can take the fillet command for lower corner. And now assign the radius 3. Press enter. Again enter. Here now again from solid editing toolbar, take a intersect and click on the both solids, this and this cylinder. Press enter. This will looks like this. Now here for threading outside of this cylinder, cylindrical bolt, we again choose a helix from draw toolbar, specify radius, a circle, specify radius, base radius is 10 and top radius is also 10. Now we specify the height of helix, which is 40, that is this is 60 from here to here, and this is 20, so we can take 40 for 60 minus 20. Press enter. Now we can draw a circle of 0.5. Use sweep command from modeling toolbar, select the circle, enter. We can also draw a rectangle or triangle on the place of circle. Now select the circle, enter, and then select the path, that is helix. This will take the okay. Now this is looks like this. Now we can take the subtract from solid editing, click on the cylinder and enter, and click on the this helical solid. Now press enter. Here it is also looking like a bolt and its thread. Now our bolt and nut and bolt is ready. Here you can also move it along this by using move command. Type this. Here we can see that these are separate. To join them, we use a command union, which is given in solid editing toolbar. Click on the union. Now click on the both solid, this and this. Now press enter. Now this is fine. Highlight only one times. Both are not separated. Now you can move this from. You can also assign material to this to look like a reality. For this you can enter MFD. Press enter. Here material library opens from which you can choose any materials which you want to apply. Here it is. Now you can choose any materials. I have chosen steel cast. Click on this and drag mouse and assign to the material. This will take the color and its property like a material cast iron. Now again click, drag and assign to the nut. You can also change the material type from this menu. Now our nut and bolt is ready. We can use orbit. To see it from all sides.